In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this topographic material. We'll be using a landscape add-on. This is how we activate the add-on. Let's add a landscape mesh. This material will look odd if we scale the landscape mesh. I'll show you how the material looks like. If your material looks like this, that means the mesh needs to shrink down a bit. If we enlarge the mesh, it will produce more topographical lines. Here are the full nodes. Basically, it's a simple diffuse and emission mixed mesh with a factor being controlled by 3 math nodes. We also have separate XYZ and the geometry node. If we don't have all of them connected the way they are, the topography won't work. I'll briefly show you what they do. Please use EV with bloom turned on. Here are the math nodes. They won't do much since the mesh is scaled too big. I have already saved a perfect mesh, so I'll show you the perfect setup shortly. I'll unhide the original mesh to show you why the mesh size is important for this material setup. This is the recommended mesh size. I'm using the same material, but they don't look the same. I wanted to include this, because it's possible for us to make good nodes and fail to notice something due to the mesh size issue like this. In the future, when you experiment math and separate XYZ nodes, please don't forget to scale them to see how they would look. Let's take a look at the shrunk mesh. I'll show you what each math node does. If any of them gets disconnected, the topography won't work. We need to have all the nodes connected to make this work. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.